atop the pole position of a possible Greater News River Conference championship, flies and whips the Jolly Roger. It's obviously a bird's eye view of a flight path. The Pirates have boarded before. Now roaring home. To double up Cleveland during the week series. Keeps them a leg up on the league. And heads them onward with a head of steam against stiffer competition. Among the impressive arsenal of set sails pitches for a tidal voyage, the main fact, they average almost as many runs per game, 11, as they have allowed all season, just 12. Which means they have left opponents behind them most of the innings this year. This is a lineup folks should stand up and take notice of. Of course, freshman pitcher Briggs McKenzie quickly sat a ram down. While working an orderly opening.
And that's a 1-2-3 inning for Briggs McKenzie and the Pirates. Nothing doing for the Rams in the top half of the first inning.
These outfield fans took the same perspective into the bottom half.
Manai, the left fielder, Ram, right.
Where Cleveland ace Skylar Locklear locked down the Pirate attack after a two-out beating.
Go!
but it was right back to the lefty Briggs for the next three jailed swingers. Though Cullen McGee was highway robbed on this line drive, Brady Dunlop was not retired as he rat raced directly up the middle. Tyler Mosley's SWAT swerved the threat around a corner. While Isaiah Faulkner's own wheels bust the lead base buddy across. Then this rally was brilliantly short-stopped in its tracks. Who believed the Pirates were on the win way? Yet, can you believe this calm, cool Cullen McGee grab at the hot corner? It certainly fired up McKenzie, who fanned his fourth.
Strikeout.
And Alex LeVake's vacuum from behind the plate sucked any more pep out of the rival. Jet Music plain old landed safely when this throw pulled the snag off the bag. The Pirates exploited such opposition oopses when McGee delivered a sack fly with extra consequences. Yeah! so that lone figure rose to three times the trouble.
Your Pirates, ready?
McKenzie might have lost his no-hitter in the fourth. But the enemy was 6-4-3 DP denied any minor victory lap. Mosley to music to Jackson Crute turned the twin keel as a well-oiled machine. Later, Mosley moseyed over to third with none gone. Yet the Rams rescinded these cha-ching chances. Imperiling the audience instead. A one-out free ticket to Cleveland saw the rival make travel plans. Hey! All unraveled when calling on Cullen. Yeah! McGee whiz. The Magic Man sure made danger disappear. A McKenzie K frenzy put an endy to the inning altogether.
Got him! Rams put the ball to play. If they leave one, they score no runs. No hits. Pirates commit no errors. At the end.
Corinth holders tuned into some rock and roll music in the fifth. LaVake hit the strong refrain like a speeding train. A single splash by Jackson Poole tabled another RBI and drenched Locklear's mound night. Smack Gee welcomed that relief. Yeah! followed by Dunlop's plop to load the pond. For Mosley to part the resistance and deliver a pair of his people to the promised land. A balk to talk about and a Jeffrey Jovino jab completed the near mercy ruling margin. Go! If there was one and only one foul up by the Pirates, it was not getting to 10 with zero outs and the clincher on. In a blur, though, a pickoff and two strikeouts forced a full game. Consider it just an opportunity to catch the Pirates a pizzazz in encore leatherwork action. Where there was never ever an easy ram reach. Nor an extended stay. Come on, Cullen. At least when Cullen the Hard, let it look difficult. Some jet fuel lofted the next Corinth holders. That's that at bat attempt.
Draws another walk.
Only to hear the music muted on a steal. Another tag target. And I can't conclusion. Until Harrison Glover and Graham Wyke combo closed with impeccable perfection protection. Thank you. hip hip hurrah, resulting in high-ranked hijinks. I'm Don Fuller, Eastwick Television.